Welcome back to The Breakfast on PLUS TV Africa. It's time for us to get to the second part of this conversation. And this morning, we'll be looking at the APC Congress that happened across 34 states, excluding Zamfara and Anambra State. Now, in all of this, in the state, the report is that all of these congresses were meted with parallel. I mean, you have the fact that there was no consensus. You have each state coming out with, you know, two chairmen and what have you. Now, in some quarters, you also have reports saying there were violence and all sort of issues, infighting. So a lot is actually going on. The big question would be, ahead of the, convention, up until this moment, the APC is not even sure when the convention would happen. But is there a possibility that there will be a convention in December or any time before December? To make sense of all of this, we do have a guest in the studio this morning with us. Not in the studio, he will be joining us virtually. And his name is Mark Adeboye. Good morning, Mr. Mark. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you so much. The name is Adebayo, Mark Adebayo.
My bad. Mark Adebayo, thank you so much for joining us.
Mark Adeboye, thank you.
Thank you. All right, so let's start off the conversation on this particular note. Looking at the Congress and all that has happened, what do you make of it? There's so much that has happened, infighting, parallel Congresses. That's what the report and the news is saying. What do you make of all of this?
But I think the relevance of this discourse is just to the extent that it affects our democracy as a country. So that is why it is relevant as a point of discussion among Nigerians. Otherwise, we just have left it at the level of internal party intrigues and us trading. But the point to make is that it is discouraging that a ruling party can be having this kind of issues, you know, that they are unable to put their house in order, they are unable to manage their differences, they are unable to manage their crisis. And this is the party to which the management of the crisis of Nigeria has been entrusted. And that is why we all Nigerians must be concerned about the way they are managing the congresses. One of the things I've discovered over the years is that parties in power tend to behave with impunity. They really don't care. They wanted power, they got the power, and whatever happens thereafter doesn't really count for much to them. So the crisis we witnessed in the last APC Congress is quite avoidable, but they have decided to just watch their dirty lining in public. If you see, if you look at it, for instance, in Edo State, where journalists were barred from even monitoring, from observing the Congress. So if you have nothing to hide, why would you say the media should not come in? It is a sign of the kind of hostage democracy that we are operating in the country. You know, we shouldn't be talking about these 20-something, over two decades after we returned to civil rule. I believe that we should have perfected the process of our congresses and conventions as political parties. And as a ruling party, one would have thought that they would lead by example and be exemplary in the conduct of their congresses, but we did not see that, what has transpired. Of course, the national body has threatened everybody not to go to court to sue, not to sue the party due to the outcome of the congresses and the rest of that. But I do believe that some people will still have to approach the court to seek for justice. Look at the violence in the Akwa Ibom State, where the youth, fearing imposition of a chairman upon them, went and burned down the secretariat of the party. That doesn't speak well for a ruling party. It doesn't speak well at all. It doesn't speak well for our democracy. Those are my concerns. And I think, let me quickly make this point. This is a big party. This is a ruling party. At the national, and they have so many state structures and local governments. They are in charge. And they are behaving this way. Now you begin to wonder, what is the essence of INEC registering political parties if the so-called big political parties cannot conduct their affairs with the discipline and the decency that a democracy requires? So, and you see that some of these, they call them fringe political parties, have better internal mechanisms, have better internal democracy mechanisms than these behemoths of political parties. Just because they have the resources, they have the government at their hands, doesn't make them better political parties. It doesn't make them a better run political party. And that is what we are witnessing now.
All right, Ms. Adebayo.
I want to, I'm not a member of the APC, but I think they should lead by example. And so that it will help, it will be helpful and healthy for our democracy.
All right, Ms. Adebayo, I want you to also share your thoughts on, it was on the Punch this morning saying that Amosun Aregbesola Lai may lose out party back to governors. You know, so I want you to share your views on the interference or seeming interference of, you know, what they've called incumbent, powers, and that's from the governors. And of course, you know, with also some certain ministers in the current administration also, Lai Mohammed and Aregbesola have been mentioned. The interference of these persons in something that should really just be a very easy process in selecting parties' leadership. What are your thoughts on that?
You see, Osage, the thing is that for both the incumbent and the former governors, whether you are a sitting governor or you are a former governor, attempting or interfering in the electoral processes of a Congress, it is anti-democratic. And what we have discovered is that sitting governors are the lords of the manor in all the political parties. What they do is that they want to dictate the outcome of what the congresses should be. And that is anti-democratic. So now you now see them in Osun State, in Kwara State, with the former and the incumbent slugging it out between themselves, you know, unleashing terror on their party members. You know, this one will bring this one, the other one will bring this one, the unleashing talks and then foulness. It doesn't speak well for our democracy. And I think it is regressing our democracy. We should not allow that. I think that is where party supremacy must come in. You see, all these governor is doing this, governor is doing that, former governor, current governor doing this. It shouldn't have a place in the democracy, in the internal workings of a political party. What should happen is that we must encourage and execute party supremacy. Let the order come from the party headquarters to the state headquarters. Let the state headquarters carry out the instructions of the party and organize the congresses. I think we should remove the interference of people in governance from direct party politics. Let the governor go in there, former and present, go in there as delegates and vote and get out. Let them not have any roles to play in who becomes what. That is where we are going to have a healthy, we are going to begin to have healthy congresses. But it's the same whereby that is why you are seeing parallel congresses in some of the states where you have the incumbent governor insisting in taking charge of the congresses. He is not an official of the party. He is not the chairman of the party in the state. He is not the secretary. He is not a member of the state executive committee of the party. Neither is he a member of the national wing committee of the party at the headquarters. Yet he wants to control everything and all the outcomes of the congresses. The former governor, believing that, look, I actually have my structures and my people. I must continue to control the party, even though I'm no longer in office. Now, clashes are inevitable. And when that comes, it is the grass that suffers the contention between two elephants. It is common delegates, the common voters, the people who don't want there to vote and go that will suffer the brunt of the summer. So we should not allow that. I think we should remove the hands of governors, incumbent governors, former governors, from the processes of party politics and congresses. Let them just be delegates, go and vote, and also get out, not to predetermine what is going to happen at congresses. Look at what happened in Lagos State, for instance. The result of the congress that was not yet aired was already out in the public by Friday morning. By Friday, from 48 hours or so, before the congresses began, results are flying out all over the place. It is not healthy for our democracy.
Ms. Adebayo, in 30 seconds, so we can wrap up, can you share with us, you know, if this also reduces the hope that you have in the 2023 general elections and the capacity of the current administration and current ruling political party to carry out free and fair and violence-free elections in 2023?
Now, if they are behaving this way among themselves, how will it, what will happen when it comes to other political parties, the opposition? it's going to be extremely violent, and we should not allow that. We should not encourage that. One would have thought that, like I'm saying, a ruling party should lead by example. So what are they? What are they contending for? What was the issue? Why couldn't they, have settled all these things before going to the Congress? I mean, you must know something. You know, there is an albatross hanging on the neck of APC now that they are not looking directly at, because the outcome of these congresses might just be a nullity at the end of the day. If some people now. Because, you know, because even within the party, some people believe that the Governor Buni's extraordinary committee is illegal, is unconstitutional. And that could render, including the National Convention, it could render everything just a nullity. And I think they should look inward. I'm not a member of the APC, but I'm just concerned for my country. I'm concerned for our democracy. 2023 is safely loaded. It's going to be the most sensitive election we have had since 1999. And all hands must be on deck. That is why, in a multi-party democracy, we must never allow a constitutional provision that deregisters political parties, so that Nigerians can have as many choices as they want. They can vote for who they want. They can organize around a philosophy that they believe in.
For the want of time, thank you so much for being part of the conversation, Mr. Mike Adebayo. Mark. Thank you so much.
Mr. Mark Adebayo. Thank you very much.
Okay. She'll get used to me. And,
thank you.
She just came to the family. And
yes, absolutely.
You know, when you're introducing yourself to one another, it could save some time. But she did not mention her name. That is another thing.
Well, I did. But my name is Mercy Boko. Thank you so much for being part of the conversation.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mercy.
All right, sir.
Well, that's so much we can take at this point in time. Definitely catch up the conversation on all of our social media platforms, on Facebook and Instagram is at Plus TV Africa, and on YouTube as well. I am Mercy Eboko.
And I am Osaugie Ogbon.